First of all, I'd like to offer my felicitations to the Mohammad Ali Jinnah University for shifting to this new beautiful campus. And I'd like to pay compliments to Mr. Shakil Ahmed for his odyssey of sad experiences through various phases of his life, which he has converted into a creative endeavor. Some people who meet difficulties get disappointed, and there are others, when they meet difficulties, they become more creative. This Ray channel is rightly named because it is a ray of hope. I was very impressed by the sentiments expressed by brilliant students, and I'd especially like to point out a few things which they stated. One speaker, I think Samia Malik, Mr. Umar Khalil, very strongly said we must stand up. Yes, it is time to stand up and be counted. If we sit and grumble and speculate, we might sink into frustration. But if we stand up, then we can move forward. Then we can reach our goal that we have before us. One young lady very confidently said, "The youth is taking over. You have a right to take over. If democracy has any meaning," and I'd slightly improve the statistics, 70% of our youth is between the age below 30. So majority has the right to rule. You should take over everything because you are 70% of the majority. Please do take over. Another important question that has been raised was the various systems of education. It's one of the curses of our society. There are not two, but multiple systems of education. And one of the systems out of that was subverted by the imperialists to train terrorists, the madrasas. And now they are using that, their own misdeed, to blame the madrasas who are giving religious education. Not all the madrasas are corrupt. In fact, for our poor people and poor population, madrasas are a saving grace, because many people who cannot afford to go to schools and who cannot even afford meals, they get free residence, free meals, and free education in the madrasas. But I believe that it is necessary to unify the system of education by reducing the gap between the curricula of various systems. And the religious education is important, but the other subjects, and our history is a proof of that. What is Pakistan? How did Pakistan come about? When Muslims were in a dire state, a man called Sir Sayyid Ahmed said that we will not give up our own culture, but we shall also take advanced education. and laid the foundation of the Aligarh movement. And I understand the time is running out because Mr. Shakil spoke at length and you have to go to other classes, so I'll cut down. He said this Aligarh movement became the Pakistan movement, and then we established Pakistan through the inspiration of Iqbal and Jinnah, and with the help of the people of Pakistan. And the ideal was to have a social justice-based society. Democracy and other things were means to that end of creating a society was based on justice. But unfortunately, we created an unjust social order inherited from the British. And unless we abolish the privileges, especially the feudal privileges, Professor Sahab very ably drew the society's picture and the differences that we create and the disrespect that we show for labor, it's actually the outcome of the feudal mentality. And if feudalism is abolished, human equality can be better established and respected. I congratulate the youth of this university for realizing that the future belongs to them. And it does belong to you. You are the future of Pakistan. And it is my sincere belief that idealism of the youth has been stimulated now to do something to save Pakistan. China is a close friend and a neighbor which became free 2 years after Pakistan. And I will close by saying one thing. What happened in China? A dedicated leadership motivated the people and released their creative energies. And they have emerged as the most important country in the world. What we need from you is dedicated leadership which can motivate the people and you release the creative energies of the nation. Pakistan will have a great future. Thank you very much.
Everybody who wants to raise a voice, to raise Pakistan, should do that because you're not unescorted. You're 69% of total population of Pakistan. You have the majority with you. What do you fear? Take the country where you want it to be, where you dream it to be. The results are with me.